Hey folks, so today I'm going to talk a little bit about, give a second vlog, talk a little bit about my own meditation experience and mention a podcast I was just on coming up. Hey folks, so I'm Doug Smith. I'm study director at the Secular Buddhist Association. That's secularbuddhism.org. And if you're interested in trying to help create a wiser, a kinder, and a less stressed out world, consider subscribing to the channel. We'll have videos like these roughly once a week on Mondays, plus a few extras here and there if I can manage to make them. And so we'll be talking about topics such as these, such as secular Buddhism, early Buddhism, and related kinds of philosophies. And if you're new to the channel, welcome. Really glad to have you here. I'll hope you'll check out some of the other videos as well, where I sort of go into some of the background here. And if you've been here before, then really glad to have you. So I've gotten some questions about my own meditation experience, which goes back quite a ways. Started meditating probably in high school, where I had a course of all things called Zen Fitness, where we did running that was supposed to be meditative kind of running or jogging, as well as formal meditation, sitting. And as I recall, the person who was giving the instructions, who was an ex-nun actually, told us to count while we were meditating, count our breaths. Only she didn't tell us to stop after 10 and go back to 1. So I remember that my first meditation experience was struggling with sort of how high the numbers could get. Not that I was necessarily always there with the numbers, but you know, you sort of get up and you're sort of wondering how far this is going to go. Later on, I realized that's really not the proper kind of technique to use. It's easier if you go back to 1, so you're not sort of trying to outdo yourself all the time. But anyway, after that, I spent quite a while doing various forms of Zen meditation at Zendo in New York once. Also at university, we sort of had a Zen group that would meet once a week. Zen in quotation marks, it was really just sort of a broad-based kind of meditation, but basically sitting meditation, quiet, following the breath kind of meditation. After that, you know, when I was in grad school, also continued doing Zen meditation at a Zendo, actually in Madison, Wisconsin. I would go probably once a week to do that. And had roughly speaking, daily meditation, maybe 20 minutes a day, 15 minutes a day kind of thing. After grad school, I gave up practice for quite a while based on my own problems with certain aspects of sort of the supernatural elements in Buddhist philosophy. I sort of couldn't make my peace with it. And the option of a secular kind of approach sort of wasn't open to me at the time. I just sort of wasn't aware of it. So put it aside for quite a while, came back to Zen meditation several years later in New York, went to, I think it's Fire Lotus Temple, which is out in Brooklyn, very, very good Zen temple, probably for, you know, sort of once a week kind of things, and they would have half-day sits, as I recall, on Saturday. I should also say that I did one weekend retreat when I was actually in college, which was a lot of fun. Difficult because I tend, whenever I go into retreats, to have a lot of back pain, knee pain, particularly back pain, and I remember struggling with that. Probably my biggest memory of that retreat actually was the food, which was, you know, not particularly exceptional, as I recall, Chinese food from a Chinese restaurant in town, was incredibly delicious, and that's probably because of, you know, sort of reduced sensory experience you're getting during sitting meditation. But that was my recollection as being, you know, and the granola cereal in the morning was just something that was extraordinary. Kind of a funny kind of recollection from a first retreat, but there you are. And after that, really, I've never done another actual retreat. And it's mostly, I think, because of time pressures, work, and a feeling of wanting to remain in contact with other people. And more recently, issues of money, you know, how much it costs to go on retreats, you know, including transportation and lodging and all the rest, has made it really difficult for me to see my way through to going to another retreat. Although, I'd be interested to hear what you guys think. How many of you guys go to retreats regularly? What do you think of them? Do you think they're really useful? My own impression is that they are extremely useful, and I really feel like it's one of the things I should be doing, but I'm not. After, you know, doing Zen for a number of years back in New York, picking up the story again, I wasn't really happy with the philosophy of Zen. I love the aesthetics, but I tend to be, coming from a philosophical background, somebody who sort of wants to make sense of these things, a skeptic philosophical background. When I met with my first experience at an Insight meditation center in New York, New York Insight, I felt like it was right for me. There was a space for secular practice, which I was at the time getting involved with. There was space for people who didn't necessarily agree with sort of notions of rebirth. You didn't have to accept them in order to practice with the center. So after that, I've really picked up a daily practice where I meditate for, roughly speaking, a half an hour, 45 minutes a day. 45 if I can manage it. And that's been really, really helpful for me, I think. That's a sort of a nutshell. Well, I should also say, one of the things, when I do practice, my daily practice, it tends to be satipatthana-based, that is to say, a mindfulness-based practice, mostly dealing with the breath, with some metta or loving-kindness practice as well. So I try to sort of bring that into my daily practice. I'll do mindfulness or mindfulness of breathing at the beginning. Then at the middle, once I've reached a sort of a state of some calm, if I can reach such a place, I'll try to do some loving-kindness as well in there. I think that's really helpful for me because it's one of my... It's a practice I find difficult, as I've said before. Putting it in every day is helpful to sort of get my, you know, get a certain amount of motivation, I think, and sort of impetus, I think, going forward with it. Then having done that, that actually does also help with samadhi, with calming the mind. Then I do mindfulness practice for the rest, and I find actually Insight Timer, if you don't know it, Insight Timer, which is both a website but mostly an app that you can put on an iPhone or iPad or other kind of mobile device. Very helpful. I'll try to remember to put a link to their site down below. It's free. There are some paid things you can do in it, as I recall, but they're not expensive. But basically, it's free. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. That's basically the kind of practice that I do every day. And I, every once in a while, will go to meetings at New York Insight. They have retreats, sort of retreats in quotes, because they really can't do an overnight there, but day longs, weekend longs. I'm outside the city right now. We have a small sangha that's starting up here where I am, more of a country kind of thing. And it's great to actually find in smaller towns around New England the sort of springing up of mindfulness-based meditation centers, and people seem to be interested in it, or just groups that start up, which I think is a really positive development. A few days ago, I did a really, really great interview with Ian Lawton at the Workshed podcast, and I'll put a link to that also down below. We talked a lot about sort of my history, getting into some of the skeptic past that I've had, my issues with contemporary skepticism, which I'm still a part of and still am positive on, but think there are things that could be changed. So again, if you're interested in that, I think it's about 45 minutes long, something like that, for the interview, and I think it came out pretty well. So I guess that's it for today. I'm really glad you stuck around to the end. Again, if you're new to the channel, really, really happy to have you here. Consider subscribing if this kind of thing interests you. Check out some of the other videos on my channel. And, well, have a great day. I'll catch you on the next one. Bye-bye.